Hi friends, based on some of my colleagues' requests, I am going to present some of the income tax calculations for financial year 2019 and 20. As per my knowledge is concerned, this chart is sufficient to get the income tax calculation, how much we need to pay and all these things. So for example, if the monthly salary is 80,000 for a person, so the annual salary should be like this, 9,60,000. So simply I multiplied with 12, so such that I will get the annual salary. But there is a professional tax of 200 rupees per month, so definitely 2400 rupees has to be reduced. And this is the taxable income, 9,57,600 rupees. But there are some deductions. One is ATC. Under ATC, 1,50,000 can be deduced, so we can claim this one. And for ATCCD by National Pension Scheme, we can take the deduction of 50,000. And by ATD by medical insurance, we can take the deduction of 25,000. And for ATG, we can donate some amount. Maybe I don't know the idea of maximum limit, but for time being, let's take 10,000 may be the amount. So we need to donate 20,000 so that we can get the deduction of 50% of it. So it will be 10,000. So all these things are the deductions, and let us see each deduction carefully after some time. And maybe home loan is also one of the best things that is also come into picture in our tax, income tax calculations. So let me calculate how much I need to pay if my salary is 80,000 per month. So let us directly go to the calculations. After that we will see what are the exact deductions. So this is my total calculation. So the salary is 9,57,600 after removing the professional tax. Here, from this amount, home loan interest should be subtracted so that the some amount will come up. So after subtracting home loan interest, so the amount is 8,19,382. So let me go back to home loan. Home loan can be divided into two things. One is principal and interest, and the interest amount paid per year can be directly subtracted from the total amount, and the principal amount per year will be considered under ATC like this. You can see here, I am showing here, this is our home loan principal. So this is reduced under ATC, and the interest deduction comes before all these deductions. So that's the advantage for the younger or newer home loan takers. So this is home loan interest. So after subtracting this part has come 8,19,382, and all other deductions, ATC 1,50,000, ATCCD 50,000, ATD 3,800, I have paid this much, and ATG is 10,000. After deducting all these things, the amount will be 2,13,800 rupees. Now I like to subtract this part from the 8,19,382. So total taxable income. So I need to pay the tax for this amount only, 6,05,582 rupees. This is my taxable income. So I need to pay the tax for this amount. So coming to latest 2019 and 20 budget, they have given no tax for up to 5 lakhs. So the margin can be divided into these parts. Up to 5 lakhs, no deduction. And after 5 lakhs, I need to give some amount. I need to pay some tax. And that amount can be multiplied with some percentage, and I will tell you the percentage also. So finally, 6,05,582 rupees, that will be divided in under two margins. One margin is 5 lakh, so up to 5 lakh no tax. Come, we can come here. from 0 to 5 lakhs, there is no tax. The percentage is 0. The amount in category is 5 lakh. So 5 lakh into 0 is 0 simply. And 50,000 here after 5 lakh, 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, they have given 20% of tax we need to pay. So it will be 20% means it's 0.2. So the amount is 1,05,582 rupees, and that will be multiplied with 0.2, so that the amount is 21,116.4. So this we need to pay. This we need to pay per annum. So per month it will come over around 1,759.7. So this is how we need to calculate for the coming budget, okay, 2019 and 2020. So let us see what are the deductions we can, that means what are the investments we can do so that we can get rid of tax. So let me explain. First, home loan should be major thing. So if you take a home and under loan, so you will get very good appreciation under from income tax. So for interest, that was directly deducted right from beginning itself. But for principal, that will be considered under ATC. Let me explain what are the things come under ATC. Under ATC, LIC can come, Life Insurance Corporation of India, where you can put some amount, maybe for 2 lakh policies, 5 lakh policies, 10 lakh policies, some other policy. There are so many policies in LIC, so you can go ahead with any one of them so that you can show the same thing for the tax benefit. And I have done for Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana, that's for if you have baby girl child, then you can go ahead with this. And I have gone for people provident fund, so I have put some amount in that also. And maybe Sundaram means it's also mutual fund, so I have done my mutual fund under Sundaram and also SBI. And between these two, there is one thing, HL principal, that is the home loan principal, that also come under this category. So if you calculate all these things, I have exactly made it for 1,50,350 rupees. So my need to invest is zero as it crossed 1,50,000. So whatever may be your investment is, but it will take up to 1,50,000 only, and it will give you the deduction up to 1,50,000 only. If you do it for 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs also, it will give you the same thing. If you do it for 1 lakh, it will take only 1 lakh, not 1.5. So please try to make it up to 1.5. That's sufficient under ATC. So come under ATCCD. So here, National Pension Scheme is one of the best scheme where you can show up to 50,000. Up to 50,000, you can show the amount under National Pension Scheme. This can be done online only. It's very easy process, and you can make it in a fraction of hours also. Okay, I will try to upload one video based on National Pension Scheme also. And coming to 80D, it's a medical insurance. So the medical insurance can be, you can show up to 25,000, but as for my case is concerned, I am paying only 3,800 rupees. And coming to next, ATG is for donation. So if you donate whatever amount you are donating for anyone for 1 year, annually, that will be given the deduction. 50% of it can be given for the deduction. So if I give, if I give 20,000 for donation, so definitely I will get the tax benefit of 10,000. So I can show 10,000, so I can ask for debit. So it will be deleted from the main taxable amount. Okay, these are the deductions. So these are the deductions we can claim, so that those will be removed, and for the remaining amount only we need to pay the tax. So let me calculate roughly how much amount I need to pay per month for these calculations. So for ATC, I need to pay 12,529 rupees. For ATCCD, I need to pay 4,200 rupees. For 80D medical insurance, I need to pay 116.67 rupees. Let's see. For donation, 1667 rupees. Let us take in round figures. So finally, the total savings per month is 18,712.5 rupees. I mean 12.5 rupees total. So in this way, we need to do the savings to get rid of income tax, and if you want, we can save more money also. But this money is very much essential, otherwise we need to pay for the government income tax in terms of income tax. So this is the whole scenario. If this is the case, I need to pay per month 1759 rupees. 15 means maybe 60. So this is the overall calculations. Of course, TDS we have already paid to bank, maybe some of the TDS, so that will be added as an extra. Maybe we are already paying some amount for income tax in the previous year, or some TDS change will be there. So that change may be roughly very less compared to, so more or less, if your salary is 80,000, you will get the payment of, so you need to pay around 1760 rupees only. So this is the case. Now I like to show you up to which salary you need not pay any tax in this year. Okay, let me take it 70,000. Yeah, if your salary is 70,000, yeah, you no need to pay anything, as your things are like this. Of course, if you take the home loan for what I have taken, maybe if it is more than that, no problem. If it is less than that, you need to pay the tax. So it will be like this. So the taxable income is less than 5 lakhs, so obviously no need to pay any tax. So if it is more than 5 lakhs, then only you need to pay the tax. So let me take directly, if your salary is 71,200 rupees, then only you need to pay the amount. Of course, for this also there is no amount. Maybe if you cross this limit, 71,000, if 71,250 rupees is your salary, then you may do it. Okay, here some error has come. I will show you this one minus. Yes, if your salary is 70,250 rupees, then you need to pay tax in this financial year. So you need to pay the tax for 582 rupees. That may come around 10 rupees per month. So this is the overall calculation. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe and try to support me. I will keep on uploading these type of videos as far my knowledge is concerned. If I commit any mistake, please write in the comment box so that I can get the latest information and I can correct myself. Thank you. Thank you so much.